Now, is it, it's still nasty, nasty neck face. You didn't drop the nasty. Nasty. Still nasty neck face.
In more capital letters than ever.
Okay.
The more caps, the better.
Nasty neck.
And you came with your own backdrop. I love this, bro.
Came with my own backdrop.
Nine Club, Halloween.
We got one guy throwing up right here.
Oh, the pumpkin's Ralphing.
Spewing.
This guy's saying sick.
What's the other dude saying?
He's just chilling.
This dude's like, I don't know these dudes.
That's me over here.
Yeah, that's Raj. It's Raj after a couple hi-fi hops. Yeah, yeah. He's like, oh, I don't even know. What? Everything good, though?
You Everything's chilling? Good, man.
Yeah, working hard, man. You guys, working you got hard. A lot of shit going on?
Halloween, October, Necktober. This is the busiest time of the year for me.
Yeah, dude.
October. And I got fucking, I got some big events. I always got big events on Halloween.
Mm-hmm.
And for a while, I try to not be the fucking the Halloween dude.
Why?
Like, I don't know. I kind of didn't want to get like
pigeonholed into that.
Pigeonholed into being the Halloween guy.
It's a hard thing to hold on all year too,
dude. And then it just became like I just
do every holiday.
I became the Halloween guy. That was it. I try to not do shit on Halloween, and fools still be hitting my phone up. What are we doing on Halloween? What do you got going? Yeah. I was like, I ain't doing nothing this year. What do you got? What do you got going? And I was like, fuck, there ain't no escaping this. So, got
to do something.
Halloween.
Well, last year you did a haunted house.
Last year I did a haunted house with Stance.
Uh huh.
And
I heard that went off. I couldn't make it, but
it went off, dude. I know a chick who showed up. She was like, I was like, you didn't even come to my show. She was like, there wasn't no parking. I was like, it took me like a year and a half to get this shit going together, and you couldn't find parking. You took off after 15 minutes.
Circled the block a couple times.
Week.
Wow. But, a year and a half.
Uber.
Seriously.
Yeah, yeah.
Where was it?
It was downtown. What street is that? Anderson Street.
It was like a warehouse.
Oh,
or
you
something
know
like
where
that,
you know where Ave did that crooked grind across the street gap.
Oh yeah, yeah.
Oh yeah.
It was on that street.
Okay.
Right
okay.
down the street.
That's quite the planning.
Yeah.
A year and a half.
Yeah. Yeah. With Stance and the I told him, I was like, I got this event because I've done this before.
Okay.
I got this event. It's a haunted house connected to an art show. And I make everyone go in through the haunted house
right.
in order to get to the art show. And the haunted house is ran by my family. My family's been doing a haunted house for like over 40 years.
What? Oh, would they turn their own house into a haunted house on Halloween? Okay.
Yeah,
wow. That explains a lot right there.
In my hometown, like I grew up into this shit, like straight up. Like my oldest brother, he used to be like, he was like in the third grade, and it all started, he'd have like a cardboard box just sitting on the front porch.
Mm-hmm.
And then all these kids would come up and he'd just jump out, right?
Gotcha.
It started like that. And then it just built up to like a huge haunted house. And like every Halloween, we'd have a haunted house in front of my house that I grew up in.
Okay.
And the whole neighborhood would come and check it out.
So it was a thing.
Yeah. We got like two storage units full of like Halloween shit.
Damn.
Oh, wow.
So the first time I did it was in Miami for this gallery. And I flew my whole family out to Miami.
Okay.
And all the stuff like on pallets and shit, like all the Halloween
props. You took the storage units and brought them.
Straight up.
Wow.
And then we did the haunted house, had people running through the haunted house. Like one of the last things that you feel is like my dad comes out with a fake chainsaw. He's like, zoom. And then fuck, just people just start booking, dude. And so you make it through this haunted house and then boom, your reward is my art show.
Okay.
And hopefully that's even scarier than the haunted house. But there was girls like, I pissed my pants. Like,
it's that scary.
Yeah. And I think it's scary because it's just like, you know, it's just my family. Like, we're not professionals and shit.
Yeah.
It's just my family. And it's like sketchy. You're like, you could see like the duct tape holding some shit up or something. And you're like, this shit might fall on my head.
Those are some of the best haunted houses.
Yeah.
Though.
So it's like you're actually like fearing for your life. And we got like, you know, I mean, we are professionals now. Like my family, like my little brother, he does like, you know, he'll be like this pig butcher guy.
Okay.
And then like my mom, she's like a witch. My aunt's like another witch holding like this witch baby and shit. And then we got my Uncle Gabriel. My Uncle Gabriel, he holds it down, but sometimes he gets a little too drunk and he like, I don't know, one year at my parents' house, he got in a fight with some chick, Wendy, who was dressed up as Wendy from Wendy's. And he was like, that fucking bitch, Wendy, she fucking hated me. She was like, he tried to scare her and she like socked him.
Oh, wow.
Or some shit. And then
it's fake.
We know like you're like the rules, like you're not supposed to touch people and shit.
Okay, yeah. Right.
But yeah, some people get fucking scared and sock my Uncle Gabriel. But yeah, we've been doing this haunted house for years, dude. And I fly my family out to Miami. Mm-hmm. Some of them never even been on a plane before.
Seriously?
Wow, put them up cool. in a hotel and shit. Wow. And then we do the haunted house. And then I did one here in LA in 2000 and was that 9 or some shit?
Oh, way back
and
then.
And it was on La Brea across the street from Undefeated. Mm. It's like a stone island building now. It's like when it was not occupied, like I took that whole place and I made it into a haunted house, had a mini ramp in there.
Oh, sick.
And had an art show and shit.
And then this year, Nectoberfest. Is Gabriel coming in? Uncle Gabriel?
Uncle Gabriel.
Flying in?
He might come in, dude. He's on the Greyhound right now.
The Greyhound takes a while.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Nectoberfest is going to be, you know, something a little more mellow. It's going to, I call it like a ghetto, like kind of Woodstock festival type thing.
Interesting.
And, and it's going to be in the parking lot of Black, my bar in Hollywood. And, it's the first time we ever had an event in the parking lot.
Dope.
And it's just going to be like, I'm going to paint all the walls in there just so people could get their fucking little Instagram photos and shit.
Sure.
And then I got a bunch of merch for sale. And then we got like a Day of the Dead mariachi band playing.
Mm.
We got Sergio from the Deftones DJing. And we got a Voodoo Ranger sponsoring. Wow. It's a beer company.
Sounds like a big event.
Yeah.
I mean, you said it's going to be mellow, but I mean, at the same time. Shit.
Yeah, it's going to be big, dude. But I'm trying to keep it as mellow as possible because I could have went really big and went somewhere else, but I was like, dude, I'm gonna keep it small.
Right.
So when I do another one, I'm be like, remember when we had that shit in the parking lot and it was all small and shit? Now we got a bigger parking lot and now we're doing a bigger event, you know?
Yeah. Right.
I gotta show the process. So I can't come in too hot.
That's right.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Is that gonna be on Halloween or?
That's on the 27th of October, which is Sunday. Halloween falls on like a Thursday or something.
Okay,
so or, Sunday before, you know, it, right?
Yeah, so.
Cool.
And I got a big ass costume contest. I told everyone to dress up as one of my characters, so hopefully someone comes in looking like this.
There you go. Yeah. Do you dress up?
I dress up, but right now I haven't thought of an idea yet. But usually, I mean, hopefully like some kind of celebrity passes away and then I'll just be that.
You're just,
That's usually your
MO.
My go-to move, yeah.
But you don't dress up as your own shit.
No.
You go as something else.
Yeah, I don't dress up as my own character.
Okay.
Yeah. I don't even wear like my own product. Like if I have to make a shirt like with my design on it, I'm not wearing it.
Why?
I don't know.
It's too much.
Yeah, I ain't trying to be like that dude. Like, hey, I'm this guy. Like, I got head to toe all shit that I designed.
Yeah,
it's like that shit is so weak to me.
You got a neck hat, shirt,
this
jacket,
yeah,
the shoes on too.
You ain't catching me like that.
Nope.